What's up, Gospel Chops?
Thank you, Gospel Chops.
What's up, Gospel Chops?
Thank you, Gospel Chops.
Hey everybody, this is Damian Erskine. I'd like to thank GospelChops.com for getting me on here and letting me talk a little bit and play a little bit. I wanted to talk a little bit about how to lock in with the groove, what works for me. I spent a lot of time when I was a kid trying to emulate the drummer with my right hand. So when I was playing a groove, I might do something like hit down on the pickups on 2 and 4, so to take a groove. And I would actually practice quite a bit just sitting on one note and trying to make a groove. I figured that helped me lock in with drummers better, so I might sit there and see if it's just that E. It's a cool way to help lock into the pocket. It's also a cool way to make your lines a little more interesting without necessarily needing to play more notes. Now that in conjunction with maybe some little trills and slides and playing with dynamics can add a lot to a line. So you can take a simple line like, and you add some of those little pops and fills and slurs in. Y'all might dig a little bit. One way to practice that is, like I said, going back, just sit on one note, or don't even play a note, forget harmony altogether. Just play along with the track and try and lock in with the drummer. So you can pull up a little bit on the string, hammer down on the pickups, you can even tap just to get rhythm with this hand. That. Give that a try, have some fun. While I got you here, I thought I might also talk a little bit about soloing, because I get a lot of emails about soloing and different ideas. And real quickly, I thought if we just take that groove I was playing before, it's kind of an E minor thing, something like a. Fool around with that a little bit in E minor. Which is cool. But after a while I might get a little bored of that just playing in one key. So I like to play around with the modes a lot. And if you're not sure what modes are, you can look it up online, but real quickly, if you take any scale, like that E minor scale, play the same notes but from a different point in the scale, you get a different scale. For example, if you start that E minor scale on G, you play all the same notes that are in an E minor scale. You actually get a G major scale. And there's 7 scales for every scale if you start, depending on where you start. So once you get comfortable with that, you can play around with some of the different modes. So if I'm soloing over E minor, to get a little bit of a different sound, I might solo over G major for a little bit. I can even solo over a Dorian. There's a lot of cool stuff you can do with that. So I thought I'd throw a little bit of that at you too. And that being said, I could go pretty far with some of this stuff, but rhythmically, you can get harmonic. Now I just thought I'd play for y'all a little bit, maybe set up a groove using the little rhythmic stuff we talked about, and then solo over top of that using some of the scalar and harmonic stuff we talked about. And a lot of people ask me about a lot of the rhythms and techniques I use, so I'll talk about that for a second. I mainly use just the normal two fingers that you would. Every once in a while, I'll use my ring finger for a quick little triplet. I use my thumb a lot to get low notes while I'm playing, especially if I'm muting. But if I play a chord, I'll use it for the bass notes and pluck the treble notes with my other fingers. And sometimes I'll combine all three. I'll do a quick little triplet and then bass note with my thumb. A lot of my rhythmic stuff came from being really into Victor Wooten. Years ago, but not really ever being able to slap all that well. So I took a lot of his stuff and just applied it to fingerstyle playing. And sometimes it's almost like a banjo player. But yeah, let me set up a little groove and just play a little bit. Let's see. Let me erase that groove first. Let's see. Thank you. Gospel Chops.
Check you later.